Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about studio construction. We get a lot of emails and phone calls from people who kind of flip the treatment and the barrier technologies. They think that treatment, which is the materials and diffusion and absorption that we use inside the room, they confuse that with sound isolation and noise transmission reduction. So let's kind of walk through the principles in our barrier, which is our shell of our studio, and not worry too much about absorption and diffusion in this process. So this is about creating a gate, a valve, if you will, against noise, keeping noise out and keeping the noise that we generate inside the room in. So it's a valve that kind of controls that. So barrier construction is really the art and science of energy draining. We're trying to take the energy that strikes the surface of our studio, whether it's a garbage truck, whether it's a neighbor yelling and screaming, whatever the noise source is, we want to make sure that we can not have it get through our barrier into our room, okay? So it's an art and a science, and we'll talk about why that is. So what do we have? We have our propagation, or our path of sound, is through the air. So the garbage truck goes by, our sound goes through the air, and then it strikes a structure. When it strikes a structure, the whole thing changes and the science changes into vibration. So now we're looking at reducing vibration, thus the term energy draining, in the barrier technology itself. Now, how do we do that? Okay. The goal in any structure, when you're designing a structure that's all about sound, and really any structure that's dealing with isolation, when the energy strikes it, it's going to change shape. Now, you're not seeing it, but it will change shape. So it changes shape, and the goal of a good engineer and a good designer is to make sure that the shape change, because it's going to change, especially with low frequency energy, that the structure gets back to what we call homeostasis or balance as fast as it can. We don't want it doing this. We don't want it moving. If a garbage truck goes by, it moves a little, but gets back to its original form quickly. And that's in the design process. And here's where the art comes in. Okay, because there's all kinds of ways to achieve this energy reduction. And this is where the experience of the design engineer comes into place. I looked at some drawings the other day of a cyclist gym in California where they have two subwoofers and they're right next to office buildings. And they sent me the drawings, and the drawings had no barrier technology at all. And how are they going to stop these two 15-inch drivers and 55 cyclists from radiating that energy through this wall, which was a 2x6 wall with building insulation in it and just drywall? How are they going to keep that from the neighbors who are working at their desks in the offices next door? They're not. So how do we do it? Experience. Methods tried, tested, failed, succeed, all kinds of. I've been doing this for 40 years. I have tried all kinds of methods for isolation. So the secret I have found, it's in the layering, it's in the density of the materials you use, and it's also in the way you put those materials together. So there's three variables that you have to consider. Let's go back to the philosophy first about what we're doing. We all know, or we've been driving on roads where the trucks go down steep hills through mountains, and they have these safety ramps for the trucks to pull off of. Well, what is the purpose behind those safety ramps? The whole purpose behind the safety ramps is energy draining. We're trying to take the forward momentum of the truck. We're going to use gravity because the ramps usually are at 45 degree angles. So as the truck goes up the ramp, it dissipates energy. Now, it's got no brakes, right? Because it's on the safety ramp because its brakes failed. So what are we doing? We're elevating it slowly and steadily. And as the truck goes up the ramp, we're draining energy. That's what we're doing. We're using gravity to drain energy, all right? Now, if we don't do our job and the truck's going a little bit too fast, what do we have at the top? We have a pile of sand for the truck to hit, or water, some kind of medium. That'll stop it, okay? But the goal is to try to get the energy to drain off the forward momentum of the truck. The same thing we're trying to do with energy in the air when it strikes a structure. We're going to have a series of layers, very similar to this. And as the energy strikes, it's going to big, little, get through the air. And then when it comes out here, it's smaller. Reduced in amplitude, reduced in strength, not frequency, but reduced in amplitude and strength. So that's our goal. Series of layers, different materials, different densities arranged. It's a little bit of an art and a science, and we're taking airborne energy, running it through a structure, and reducing it. Hope that helps. Don't confuse it with absorption and diffusion. Completely different science. There is some overlap, but the key to the understanding of barrier technology is understanding the differences and the likenesses between the two sciences. Thank you. Thank you for watching our videos. We really appreciate your support. And if you could give us a thumbs up for our Facebook page, that would really be helpful to us. Our room form gives us all the information about your room, length, width, height, usage, and we need you to fill that out before you send it in. Those of you that just found us on the internet and are under a time crunch, you can go to the contact section of our website, and there's a book now button so you can book an appointment with us, but make sure I have your room form to go on with it. The ebook series that we have is free. Please subscribe to that. There's exclusive videos in there so you can get an idea of your particular situation, possibly with the videos. And then our forum. We have a forum on our website. There's a lot of forums out there on the internet. Our forum will actually answer your questions and comments, so you'll be dealing directly with me through our forum. So once again, thank you for your support.